Today we have a 2017 Nissan Sentra. We're replacing the catalytic converter. So we're under the vehicle here. Go ahead and turn this light on. So the cat is actually boom, this whole piece here versus, like, you know, some vehicles would be part of the exhaust manifold. So it's 4 bolts, 2 up there, 2 back here. I already had and sprayed some WD-40, let it soak for a minute because I know it's going to be a pain. The first thing we're going to do to start off, we're going to go ahead and get this O2 sensor out of the way since we have some leverage with it being attached to the vehicle. Pop it off here, unplug it, which it's kind of cold out here, so my fingers hurt. And then with a O2 sensor wrench socket or a 22, we're going to take out the O2 sensor, and then we're going to get down to taking these off. All right, my O2 sensor has been removed. Makes it easier for me later. 2 bolts up there, 2 back here, all number 14. I'm going to take these out first, and then with an extension with 14, I'm going to remove those two there. I already broke these two, and it came out pretty easy after I let them soak in WD-40 for like 10-15 minutes. No big deal. So let's get this off and we'll get the new one installed. So I've removed all the bolts. I'm just going to pull it back a little and slide it out. All right, our old cat removed, our new one here. But before we do anything else, let's go back up here. Remove that old gasket here. We're gonna be replacing this gasket right here, so I'm about to get like a little flathead and just kind of knock that out. Also, we got to remove this here, this little plug for the O2 sensor. I already loosened it, it's number 8 Allen, to get that out. And then also, you can see here the back here, those have some welded on nuts basically to put those in. So we have to use the new hardware that comes with it. It's just gonna be the same concept, the spring and the bolt. I might end up actually just using the original, because we're going to use the original on this side and just using the nut to hold it in place. So let's get that old gasket on and make sure to replace this gasket on the new one to add the new ones in. Let's see, that one is still on there. So we're going to pop all those on and pop this in. So I had a little trouble. Obviously, it was aftermarket, so it's a little shorter. So I had these little fours. Basically, up there, you got to push them in with those little springs. Once I got those threaded, all good. So I just gotta tighten it later using a T-bar to hold it in place. Now back here, I'm gonna have to kind of push this forward a little bit just to get this going. Now I'm gonna continue using the old hardware with a new nut here for the other side instead of this garbage here. Like, what is this? I don't even want to use that. So pretty much I'm just gonna put this here, the nut on the other end, kind of push it forward and kind of hold it in place, get it all threaded, and we'll tighten everything down at once. So I had a little trouble trying to use two hands, you know, one to hold the nut, one to push this forward. So a little trick I did was get a C-clamp and just kind of tighten it up a little, bring that all forward, give me enough room to do the nut and the bolt there. So gonna go ahead and get this together and we'll tighten it. Okay guys, so we got these tightened down as well as up there. Now I'm not entirely sure what the torque is, but if you can look up there, you'll see that it kind of has like a stopper. So pretty much just went all the way there and give it a nice little snug fit just to make sure everything is good. And that's pretty much it. So now we're all done. All I gotta do now is install our new O2 sensor. As you can see, if they kind of relocate it, which is gonna be kind of weird. Hopefully it fits accordingly. It should. So pretty much that's all we gotta do now, clear the check engine light, and we're done. So thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, more videos to come.